MCrider is all about riding a motorcycle more skillfully and with better road strategy out on the street. But how do we share our love of motorcycling with our significant others? Well, one of the best ways to do that is to take them as a passenger on a ride. This is one of the most requested videos that I've had on MCrider, and our $5 patrons have requested this, so I'm going to do a couple of videos on riding with a passenger. And this week on MCrider, we're going to start with the backseat, and we'll give you some tips and techniques to be a better passenger on a motorcycle. Then next week, we'll focus more on the front seat. Hey, my name's Kevin. I'm the host here at MCrider, where I release a weekly video every Friday morning on road skills or road strategy to help make you a better rider. Hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notifications of future videos, and I hope you'll consider supporting the channel on YouTube as a member or on Patreon at mcrider.com/support. And as a way of saying thank you for supporting the channel, you'll get access to the field guide and the MCrider forums. Riding with a passenger is one of our most requested videos here on MCrider, so we're going to focus a couple of weeks on this, and we're going to start this week with tips for passengers on how to be a better passenger on a motorcycle. So before you hop on the back seat with somebody else on a motorcycle, here are a few things you may want to consider and a few tips to help make you a better passenger on the back of a motorcycle. If you're going to be the passenger on the back seat of a motorcycle, you want to make sure that you're comfortable with the skill of the person controlling the motorcycle. Riding with the passenger on the back is not the time for that person to learn how to ride. They need to be very adept at starting and stopping a motorcycle, knowing that cornering is going to be different, that braking distance is going to be different, that the motorcycle is going to be harder to handle at a stop. So you want to make sure that the rider of the motorcycle or the pilot of the motorcycle is experienced. You may want to check and see if they have their license. In my opinion, a rider who's riding without a license either doesn't take their riding seriously or they have a lot of concerns that they may not be able to pass the rider's test if they go in and actually try to get some training on this. So if they don't have a license, means they probably have not had any formal training, and you probably want to consider whether or not you want to get on the back of the motorcycle with that type of rider. It's important before you get on a motorcycle to have your own safety gear. That would be helmet, jacket, gloves, boots, pants, all the gear that the rider of the motorcycle would need. You're going to need that for yourself as well. And in particular, you want to make sure that the helmet is correct fitting. You can't just borrow any helmet and put it on and hope for the best. You want to make sure that that helmet fits you. An easy way that you can test that, put the helmet on, put the chin strap on, reach to the back of the helmet and see if you can forcefully pull up on the back of the helmet and see if you can roll that helmet off your head. If the helmet comes off, it's likely too big for you. You want to find something that's going to fit you correctly because that's going to be your biggest line of defense in case there is an accident. Know beforehand the type of motorcycle that you're going to be riding on. I have two motorcycles sitting behind me. The Harley Road King has a nice passenger seat with a touring pack from Edvan Black. It's got a wraparound backrest. It's got floorboards for the passenger. While the Yamaha XSR 900 has foot pegs, but they're mounted up very high due to the design of the motorcycle. And then it's got this thin plank of a piece of foam for the passenger to sit on. There's no backrest, no other creature comforts for the passenger. Which one would you rather ride on the back of? So while some motorcycles can carry two passengers, it may not be very comfortable for any length of time. So you want to know what type of motorcycle you're going to be riding on. That's going to make a huge difference for you on the back seat of the motorcycle. But at a minimum, it does have to have a back seat. You don't want to sit on the fender of the motorcycle. And it has to have a place for you to put your feet, either footrest or floorboards, place to comfortably rest your feet. Handrails also help, but they're not an absolute necessity. But at a minimum, rear seat and floorboards or foot pegs for the passenger. As a passenger, it's important to know where the hot parts of the motorcycle are. Motorcycles get surprisingly hot, and it catches a lot of passengers off guard. Exhaust pipes are going to put a quick burn on your leg if your leg brushes up against it, or if your boot sits on it as you're going down the road, it's going to melt the rubber on the boot and cause issues there. When my girls were much younger, I'd pull into the garage after a ride, and the first thing they would do is come out to the garage to greet me. They're getting to be about teenagers now, and they don't even care if I get home. But when they were younger, they would run out into the garage and they would greet me, and I would hop off the motorcycle and, whoa, 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 hot, you know, don't touch it. And I'd try to cut them off before they got to the motorcycle because I knew that'd be the first thing they'd do is put their hands on it. So it's important to know where those hot parts are and to have that figured out before you hop on the back of the motorcycle, and just be aware of that as you're getting on or off the motorcycle once it's warmed up. Before you get on the back of a motorcycle, you're going to want to develop some signals, some way to communicate. So that may be tap them on the side and, hey, slow down, or I need a break, pull over. But some way to communicate, because talking on a motorcycle at road speed, especially with helmets on, is virtually impossible. So you want some way to communicate back and forth. And the best thing for that is a Bluetooth communicators. So if you plan on riding frequently, you may want to look at investing in some Bluetooth communicators. They also make great Christmas gifts. So I'll have a link to those at mcrider.com/talk. And you can purchase a set of these. This is going to link you to Revzilla, an affiliate link. And they've got a great breakdown of all the different options. Some of these come in pairs. They're already paired up and synced together. So you just install them on the helmet, and it makes a world of difference communicating back and forth, but between the pilot and the passenger on a motorcycle. It's a huge benefit. So I consider having you look at those if you're going to ride with somebody frequently. You're going to want to practice getting on and off the motorcycle. Now, there's a lot of different ways to do this. Whether you get on first, which may be helpful if the motorcycle's got a tour pack on it like my Road King does, makes it easier sometimes if the passenger gets on first, or if the rider's on first, whether they want the motorcycle upright and both feet on the ground, or to leave the motorcycle on the side stand and have you get on the motorcycle that way. All of that is going to be a discussion between you and the pilot of the motorcycle, but make sure that you know that beforehand. And don't surprise the pilot of the motorcycle by getting on or off when they don't expect it. Make sure that they know that you're getting on or off, because remember, they have to balance the weight of that motorcycle as you're moving around on it. So it's important that you don't catch them off guard. When you're seated on the back of the motorcycle and riding down the road, it's important where you place your hands. Some motorcycles have built-in handrails for the passenger to hold on to. If the motorcycle doesn't, or you don't feel comfortable holding on there, you can hold on lightly around the waist or gather up the jacket of the rider in front of you, kind of make some handles out of that. You can hold on there loosely. But what you don't want to do is get your hands up on their shoulders or their arms as they're riding the motorcycle. That's going to affect their ability to go through corners. But in particular, if you have to brake heavily, in an emergency situation, if your hands are up on the top or up high on the rider's shoulders, you're going to be pushing them more forward as they're trying to control the motorcycle. So you want your hands down low around the waist or on the handrails if the motorcycle has those built in. As the passenger of the motorcycle, your feet stay on the floorboards or the foot pegs the entire time that you're riding. So there's no need to put your feet down at a stop. Your feet stay up on the footrest. And you may want to just balance your weight between those footrests and the seat to help make the bike be more balanced as you're riding down the road. But no need to take your feet off. In fact, it's going to make things worse for the pilot of the motorcycle if you're shifting your feet around or trying to put your feet down at a stop. So you want to be as steady as you can be on the motorcycle, but if you're going for a longer ride, sometimes it's just necessary to adjust your seating position. The main thing for doing that is make sure you notify the pilot beforehand before you adjust around on the motorcycle. So that's where the Bluetooth communicators come in, or the hand signals that you've prearranged to let them know, but you just want to signal to them before you start moving around on the bike in any significant manner that you're getting ready to do so. For me, as the pilot of the motorcycle, it's more beneficial to me if the passenger makes those adjustments while the motorcycle is moving. So 25, 30 miles per hour on up helps make it easier for me if the passenger is making adjustments, if I know about it ahead of time, because then the bike holds itself up. And at a stoplight, if they're making any kind of big adjustments, it can catch you off guard and you have to hold the weight of that motorcycle up as they're moving and shifting around. So for me, it helps if their motorcycle is underway when they make those adjustments, but that's something you'll want to talk about or prearrange with the pilot of the motorcycle before you get out on the road. One thing that catches a lot of new passengers off guard when they ride on the back for the first time is the motorcycle leaning through the corners. Catches them off guard, and it's something that feels unnatural. And their natural tendency may be to lean against it. So the motorcycle's leaning to the left. They may want to lean to the right. But really, your upper body, your torso should be mostly stationary. You don't want a whole lot of movement back there. The best advice that I can give for a passenger as they're riding with a pilot on a motorcycle is, if they're going to the left, is to lean slightly and just look over that inside shoulder of the corner that you're going around. So if you're leaning to the left, you're going to look over the left shoulder of the rider of the motorcycle. If you're going to the right, you're going to look over that right shoulder of the pilot of the motorcycle. But there's no need to try to lean with them to get way off the motorcycle or to counterbalance the motorcycle as they're going around a corner. You just need to be predictable on the back of the motorcycle. And the best way you can do that is to keep your upper body movements to a minimum. And the last and maybe one of the biggest pieces of advice I can give to you as a passenger is to be predictable on the motorcycle. You don't want to catch the pilot off guard. You don't want to do something that they're not expecting to happen. That's why communication is important, either through Bluetooth or hand signals. But just make sure you're a predictable passenger on the motorcycle, and before you do something of any consequence, that you've communicated that with the rider or the pilot of the motorcycle. What tips do you have? I'd love to hear some tips from you guys as passengers, things that you tell your passengers on the motorcycle that help you control the motorcycle better. Or if you have significant seat time on the back of a motorcycle, what are some things that I've left out? Truth is, I've never been on the back of a motorcycle. I've never ridden with somebody else, so I'm sure there's a lot of you who've got tips that I've left out and things that are important that you want to share. Leave those in the comments below or join us on the forums, where we'll continue the discussion of this video and a whole lot of other topics and techniques to help make you a better rider, and for us all to learn from the experience of other riders out there. So until next week, guys, this is Kevin with MCrider, and we'll see you on the road. MCrider is made possible by our friends on Patreon. To learn how to support MCrider, get access to the field guide and the forums, go to mcrider.com/support.